John and Shannon, I appreciate you allowing me to have this opportunity to be with you today. I remember the first time that I met you guys. You were in church, and I thought for the longest time you were already married. And I bet it was maybe almost a year after I was here that you finally instructed me that you weren't. John told me when we met earlier in the week that he wanted to kind of keep it a secret, his thoughts, how he wanted to make it a surprise for Shannon on the day that he asked him. So whenever his friends would ask him when he was going to get married, he would always fluff it off like it was going to be a long time. One of the things, as I was meeting with them, that they shared with me was they have a great faith. And it's really edifying to see that their relationship really is built on the church and their relationship with God. They made it a part to remain God a part of their lives. And that's unique for young people. It's unique that they would want that for themselves. Each of them sees the other as a great gift to themselves and for their lives. John said that Shannon was someone, and the reason that he was attracted to her is that she's so good to her family and friends. And that it just makes him just feel good about her. He feels always comfortable in her presence, and likewise for him. Him for her. She knows he'll be a good provider. He's very responsible. I'm surprised he was telling me before Mass today that they close on their house. A lot of new things happening in their life. God taking care of them. Because they're responding to the gifts that he's given them. And we look for examples of God's presence in our lives. We look for him, we search for him. We hear his word and we strive to drum him up in our hearts. But really the way that we see God, the way that we find him, is through the presence of other people. Today John and Shannon take a step. They're going to model for us God's love. They're going to show us what covenant is all about. God makes a covenant with us, and they make a covenant with him and to each other. And that covenant is an example to us of commitment and God's law, through thick and through thin, good times and bad, sickness and health, that they will be true to each other as God's true to us. No matter what happens in our lives, he will never abandon us, and they will never abandon each other. And that is what we pray for today. We pray for them, and we're grateful for them coming and making this great witness to us. They don't make that commitment and that witness alone. They've had great examples in their lives. I was talking to both of their parents, to Tom and Nancy, to Rhonda and Jim the other day. They've each been married for 27 years. I think Tom and Nancy just celebrated theirs Thursday. Their 27th anniversary, and Jim and Ron celebrate their 28th in about a month or so. So together, John and Shannon have had an example of commitment, what love really is that never-ending and always true to each other. The second reading spoke about all the things that make up what love is. And so today, they're here to model that for us, and we're here to pray for them. We want them to be successful. We want them to experience the joys of this day, experience the joys of love in their lives. We do hope that today is not the happiest day of your life. I sure hope that the happiest day of your lives is those ahead of you. That when you sit out here with your parents someday, sit in their space, in their place, and you watch your children coming up here, and your grandchildren experiencing this. you remember this day as a great day, but not the best day. The best day is that you sit there in your space, as your parents do today, that you will remember that the best days of your life are ahead of you. That as you experience children and moments in your life and struggles and challenges, and as you get through those, you will remember that God's love for you just images, and your love for each other is just a small bit of what you're about to experience. That each and every day of your life you will grow in knowledge and love for each other. And at the end of your lives you will give thanks to God for the gift of your life.